Welcome to the FACE, Family and Community Engagement Link. How are you guys?
Doing great. How are you doing?
I'm doing absolutely wonderful. Oh, look at all the kindergartners. Hi, hey, how are you guys?
You say hey?
Hi. Hi, my name is Mr. Langford. So, what school do you guys attend?
Tell them what school.
We schooled a long time ago.
Fernway, say Fernway.
Fernway. And what about you?
Boulevard.
Well, I'm so glad you guys are able to join us. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just share a little bit of information with you guys about the Family and Community Engagement Center and myself so that you just have an idea of who I am and what I do. So I'm going to do a quick screen share and we'll probably have a few other folks join us as they leave some of the other meetings, okay? All right, so here we go. Let me make sure I get the right screen first. Just give me one second here. All right, we're all set now. Okay, again, my name is Keith Langford. I'm the Family Community Engagement Coordinator for the school district. And the information that I'm going to share with you today, I kind of put this information together at the beginning of the school year. So what I want to do is just share a little bit about myself. Well, who is Mr. Langford? All the kids call me Mr. Langford. The majority of the parents call me Mr. Langford. My full name is Keith Langford. You guys can call me either Mr. Langford or Keith. I'm cool with that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to share in the chat a link to this exact presentation so you'll be able to view it at a later time. So I'm not going to go through the whole entire slide word by word. I just wanted you to have a little bit of information about myself, about family community engagement, what we do, and how we can, how we're here to support you as a parent, and we're also here to support students, okay? So this little bio here, it just talks a little bit about myself, but I'm not gonna read this again. What I'm gonna do is share with you guys that my wife and I, we have lived in Shaker Heights for, it's either 24 or 25 years. We raised our three children in Shaker. We used to actually live in the Onaway area. And our oldest daughter, she attended Onaway Elementary School. Of course, she went all the way up, all the way through. And then our son, Kyle, he attended Lomond Elementary School. And then our youngest daughter, Kimora, she also attended Lomond Elementary School. So I've been in Shaker for 24 plus years and I love it. I live in the Lomond community, just to let you guys know where I'm located. All right, secondly, a lot of times people have a question, well, what exactly is family and community engagement? So here's a brief definition of family and community engagement. And basically, without me reading this particular slide, family and community engagement is all about support. It's about support and providing resources to families and children to basically help children with their early learning, help children with their development, all the way from birth, all the way through post-secondary. And so family engagement is really about providing partnerships and support and resources. Now, my role as the coordinator for family community engagement, my role is to provide partnerships, enhance the children's education, and I provide outreach services. I also supervise the district FACE liaisons. And in each building, there is a face person that you will be able to connect with that will be able to support you, help guide you, help you navigate through the Shaker school system, okay? I also work very closely with the community. I work closely with PTO, providing activities, events, all those types of things. So you'll see me in your kids' buildings. You'll see me out in the community. And please don't be shy. Please say hello, as everyone does. Now, I do have one request. When I'm in Heinen's, don't keep me in the in the bread aisle for 30 minutes. but no, all jokes aside, please feel free to say hello, ask me any questions, and I'll do the best I possibly can to answer those questions, okay? The mission for the FACE Center, the Family Community Engagement Center, will collaborate with groups, organizations to develop outreach activities, programs, and partnerships. And again, I'm going to provide you guys with a link so you will be able to view these slides later. In each building, as I mentioned, we have what's called the FACE liaison. And those individuals are there to provide additional support. They'll provide additional support to you and your children as needed. So for an example, we have families that they may need some outside resources, meaning it's not academic based. But maybe there's a community resource that they need or that they're interested in. So your FACE liaison will be able to assist you with that. As far as academics are concerned, the FACE liaison can act as that person that can connect you with the teacher, the building principal, if a student has special needs or anything of that nature, they can help again, coordinate, guide you guys through that particular process. Now we use a tiered system. So we have what we call like a tier one. Tier one is the families, hey, listen, you know, your kids come to school, everything's going great. You know how to navigate the district webpage. You can find all the resources you need. You've built relationships with the building principal, the classroom teacher. So that's basically tier one. You know how to find the resources and the supports that you need. Tier two is when we get into more of a collaboration. Hey, Mr. Langford, I'm an engineer. I'm an artist. I do this as a hobby. So I would collaborate with you and the building administration. We would come together and we could just see how we can work together. And we would be able to bring some amazing events, activities, and programs to the different school buildings, okay? So that's roughly like your tier two, where I'm just connecting with individuals, partnerships, and the community. Tier three is where we get into, sometimes families need a little more support. There could be different types of crises that happen. So for an example, Lord forbid, but let's say for example, someone has a fire, right? During and after that fire, you may need clothing, you may need a place to stay, you may need furniture. There are a lot of different things that you may need. Well, in my role as the FACE coordinator and the liaisons in your building, we can guide you in the right direction. We can connect you with other individuals, other organizations that might be able to assist and help you out. Also, I am also the district McKinney-Vento liaison for the district. And so the McKinney-Vento is an act that was created to help and support and protect families that may experience a temporary housing issue. So for an example, something may happen where you may be temporarily displaced. You may end up having to move for any particular reason and move in with another family member. It's my job to then work with you, work with the building principals and your students, just to make sure that the educational process is not interrupted. And then also, make sure that if any transportation is needed from your new location, that we can then provide that needed transportation, okay? In 2020 and 21, the priority of focus was just basically following the strategic plan, the strategic objective 2.3. And That can be found on your district webpage. Just look up under strategic plan and you'll see all the different objectives that has been laid out for the district to follow for the next 5 years. As it relates to family engagement, our focus is clear. Our focus is really making sure that we help families and students during COVID-19 provide support resources, collaborate with the community, provide students with the tools that's needed and necessary for success. So for an example, you know, we had students that needed hotspots. We had to make sure that students had computers, school supplies. Your kindergartners may need some school supplies, backpacks. We want to make sure that your kindergartner has everything that they need in order to be successful, okay? Also, one of the focuses is enhancing our partnerships with our families, building better relationships with our families, having a clear, frequent communication, right? Making sure that we have the correct mailing address, the updated mailing address, the updated cell phone numbers, the updated email accounts, so that we can stay in contact with you if necessary. And then on this page, what I'm sharing here, and these are some links. And again, I'm going to provide you in the chat box when we get to questions and answers, I'm going to provide you guys with the link to this PowerPoint. But these blue links here, you can click on them and it'll take you to a page where you can find more information. So for an example, the Virtual FACE Academy. So when we're in person, we have in-person what we call FACE Academies. Some school districts call them parent universities. And so this is an opportunity for us to survey our families, see what information they're interested in. And then what we do is we organize and provide a program based on that information. The Shaker Engagement Collaborative, that's another partnership with the community where we come together and we share resources. You'll find that information. All you have to do is click on that link. COVID-19 support and communication. That can also be found on the district's webpage. You want to make sure that you read that and know as much about that as possible. This is where you can find your COVID-19 dashboard, anything related to health-related issues as we are moving forward through this COVID-19 pandemic. The Shaker Heights Parent Teacher Organization, or PTO, there's more information there. And then we have the FACE website. And on that website, there's a link that you can click on if you're interested in volunteering. And I would encourage you to volunteer. National research has shown and proven that when families get involved in their kids' education at an early age, that the kids actually do better. So volunteering in the schools will help, trust me. It will build those relationships with the teachers, build those relationships with your parents, I'm sorry, building principals. And then you just know what's going on. You're in the loop. The more you volunteer, the more you're involved, the more you're engaged, you're in the loop and you know what's happening. And I'll tell you a little secret. When you enter in the building and teachers and building principals recognize your face and they know your name, amazing things can happen for your kids. Right? So just keep that in mind. That's just a little gold nugget I can give you, but keep that in mind as your kids move throughout the school district from kindergarten to 12th grade, okay? All right, next steps, we're gonna work on some summer planning. We're going to make sure we continue to align with the strategic plan. And a big thing that we're doing is we're working with the National Network of Partnership Schools. And we joined what's called a cohort group. There's 18 schools in the state of Ohio. And we've joined that cohort group. And it's all about building better relationships and partnerships with parents. For an example, in that link, here's the information. You can find that. And then the question and answers. Here is my contact information. And then I am going to close this. I'm going to go to the chat. I'm going to put the link for this particular presentation and you guys can find it later. Any questions? Awesome. Well, listen, it is, I believe, 2 o'clock. And if there are no questions, you guys enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you. You as well.
Thank you, Keith.
All right. Thank you.